Dear viewers, Namaskar. Welcome to this edition of the News Bulletin in the headlines today. Bearing seat of top universal spindle machine of plate mill successfully reconditioned. Brainstorming sessions and technical talks mark the International Conference on Sustainability in Metal Industries. And senior officers' cricket match played amidst fun and camaraderie. Now the news in detail. A bearing seat of top universal spindle machine of plate mill was successfully reconditioned at mechanical shop of Sale Rourkela steel plant amidst several constraints because of the dedication, commitment and dexterity of the team. This endeavor of shop mechanical team collective has brought about substantial savings for the company. Notably, the top universal spindle of plate mill is a critical spare for functioning of mill stand. The spindle attached with motor gives drive to mill stand work roll. There are two universal spindles available in plate mill and during capital repair, the spindle in use gets replaced with standby spindle. During one of the inspections, an abnormal sound was noticed during spindle rotation. On dismantling it, it was found that there has been uneven erosion of two numbers of bearing seat. This universal spindle was of 450 mm diameter, 9.8 meter long and weighed approximately 18 tons. The only solution to address the issue was to grind the bearing seats for bearing fixation. On discussions with mechanical shop, it was found out that the capacity of existing lathe machine has a capacity to carry 12 tons of load, but the spindle weighs about 18 tons. The team of mechanical shop accepted the challenge and after micro planning, they started working in development of additional two numbers of roller steady rest with the technical support from design department. Both the steady rests were fabricated, machined and made ready with the available lathe machine. After receipt of universal spindle from plate mill, it was loaded in long lathe machine and held between centers. Two fabricated roller steady rests were placed below spindle over bed of machine to share additional load. The job setting was done, suitable tooling for machining and grinding was arranged. Now the turning of one bearing seat is over and the second bearing seat will be completed shortly. After completion of turning operation, grinding of both the bearing seats will be carried out with the help of a grinding attachment of machine to achieve desired surface finish for bearing fixation. It is worth mentioning that a new spindle costs about Rs 1.3 crores and a minimum time of 1 year is required to complete the total procurement action. The in-house reconditioning cost of existing spare is Rs 40 lakhs. The enterprising job of the shop's mechanical, which is expected to be completed in another week, will earn a substantial savings of at least Rs 40 lakhs for RSP. Brainstorming sessions, technical talks, exchange of ideas and best practices mark the two-day-long National Conference on Sustainability in Metal Industries held at Indo-German Club of Sale Rourkela Steel Plant RSP on 2nd and 3rd February 2024. The event was organized by Indian Institute of Metals, Rourkela chapter in association with Sale Rourkela Steel Plant and NIT Rourkela. The concluding session was chaired by Mr. S.K. Basak, Chairman IIM Kolkata Chapter. Present on the dais were Mr. Goam Bhatia, CGM, EMD Sale, Brigadier A. Ganguly, Secretary General IIM, Head Office Kolkata, Professor B.C. Ray, NIT Rourkela, Professor Soumya Sarkar, IIM Ranchi and Dr. Agya Majumdar, Director, Kazi Nazrul University. Mr. Atish Chandra Sarkar, Secretary, IIM Rourkela Chapter and CGM Quality RSP presented a brief about the event which was followed by an open house feedback session. The two-day conference concluded with the remarks of the chair in which he reiterated the importance and the dire need of the day to adopt strategies and technologies to bring about sustainability in metal industries. Ms. Ankita Bilung, Senior Manager, RCL, anchored the event. The two-day technical session had a galaxy of luminaries from across India who shared their valuable insights on various topics in the parallel sessions. On the first day, the subjects covered were green pellet in sintering process, metal and mining train, role of hydrogen in green technologies, TRL Kurosaki refractories, green steel making initiatives, use of BOF slag as fertilizer, aluminium injection in Philly, aluminium killed steel grates for reducing aluminium consumption, laser spray technology, use of coke oven waste in coke making, and energy management in sustainable development. The second sessions were on energy conservation initiatives without capital expenditure, biomass as an alternative fuel, usage of coal brick in DRI operation, utilization of LD slag, transforming Indian cement industries through CCUS, eliminating constraints in the mini blast furnace charging system, digitalization in coal yard management, and refractory interaction during HDRI, that is hydrogen based direct reduced iron in liquid iron melt, a green perspective. The senior officers' cricket match was held amidst fun and camaraderie at the Ispat Stadium on 4th February. Mr. Atanu Bhaumik, Director in Charge, Mr. S.R. Suryavansi, ED Works, Mr. Somnath Tripathi, EDMM, Mr. Tarun Mishra, ED P&A, Mr. Alok Verma, ED Mines, Mr. A.K. Behuria, ED F&A, and several chief general managers and other senior officers participated in a 12-overs tour side cricket match. The match was played between DIC 11, led by Mr. Atanu Bhaumik, and ED Works 11, led by Mr. S.R. Suryavansi. DIC 11 won the toss and elected to bat. The players of both the sides gave the best. Some outstanding instances of batting, bowling, fielding, and catches were witnessed in the match. The DIC 11 team emerged as the winner in the tough competition. The best bowler title was backed by Mr. Alok Verma, ED Mines, who was playing for the ED Works 11 team. Mr. Prakash Maharana, HEM DIC Secretariat, and playing in the DIC 11, won the Best Batsman Trophy, while Mr. Riki Agarwal, Senior Manager, ED Works Secretariat from the ED Works 11 team, was declared as the Man of the Match. The awards were presented by Mr. Atanu Bhaumik and Mrs. Seema Dev Bhaumik, President, Deepika Mahila Sangati, presented the awards. Mrs. Pravati Mishra and Mrs. Namrata Verma, both Vice Presidents, Deepika Mahila Sangati, and spouses of many other senior officers were also present on the occasion. Mr. R.K. Verma, GM, PHSW Sports and Airport, Mr. Raghunandan Padhi, Deputy Manager Sports, and other employees of Sports Unit coordinated the event. Mr. Faraz Abbasi, DGM, CNIT, and Mr. Chayakanta Tripathi, MOMT, SMS2, were the umpires, while Mr. Devananda Bhoi, OCT Technical, CNIT was the scorer, Mr. Vidhi Karnail Singh, GM in charge, MM Purchase, and Mr. K. Bhuya, GM, T&RM, and Mrs. Archana Satpathy, GM, PR, and COC were the commentators. And with this, we come to the end of this news edition. Namaskar.